My colleague Ankit Tyagi is live now. He's joining us from Ayodhya. Ankit, ahead of the Bhoomi Pujan, the temple town is getting ready. It's a festive mood. We usually say let's paint the town red, but in this case, they're all painting the town yellow.
Absolutely, Chaiti. It's all been painted yellow. I am at the very iconic, famous Ram Ki Pairi. This is where, in fact, if you can see behind me, everything is yellow and massive work. Preparation work is going on, cleaning of these stairs. I'll show you all these workers there because Ayodhya wants to put the best foot forward when the Prime Minister and the dignitaries come here for the groundbreaking ceremony, for the Bhoomi Pujan ceremony of, in fact, the Ram Temple. Now, the holy city is completely getting a makeover from all the houses, buildings, approach road, across the approach road being painted yellow, to, in fact, the highways getting ready. And all across, there is a festive sort of atmosphere. With just 2 days to go for the grand opening ceremony, as far as Ayodhya's Ram Temple ceremony is concerned, Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath is expected to visit the temple town to oversee the preparations. Yogi Adityanath will reach by 1 p.m. In just about, in fact, he's about to reach the city and will oversee preparations. He will be here till late in the evening. Meanwhile, soil from 1,500 places, water from 100 different rivers have been brought to the temple town for the construction of the Ram Temple. Prime Minister Modi is going to be at this event. He will be on the stage with Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, RSS Chief Mohan Bhagwat, former Ayodhya litigant Iqbal Ansari was the first to get an invite as well. Modi will lay the foundation stone of the temple. He will arrive at about 11:15 a.m. He is expected to go to Hanumangari temple to offer the prayers. That's a tradition. I mean, in fact, everything that starts in Ayodhya starts at the Hanumangari temple. And then we'll head to the Ram Janmabhoomi complex. He will lay 5 bricks made of silver during the auspicious Abhijit Muhurat at 12:15 p.m. That will be on Wednesday, August 5th.
तैयारियां हो गई हैं, बाकी की तैयारियां हो रही हैं. देश के मूर्धन्य महात्मा संत बधा रहे हैं और मोदी जी और योगी जी तो रहेंगे ही. इसके अलावा देश के महान संत कृपा करके आ रहे हैं. बड़ा दिव्य और भव्य आयोजन होगा.
देखिए, 9 नवंबर को सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने जो है मुकदमे का फैसला हो गया. पूरे जो है हिंदुस्तान के मुसलमानों ने कोर्ट का सम्मान किया, इसलिए हम मुसलमान हैं, हिंदुस्तान का संविधान मानते हैं. अब जो है कोई झगड़ा नहीं है हिंदू मुसलमानों का. सवाल आज है, आज हमें यह जो कार्ड मिला है, अयोध्या धर्म की नगरी है और हमारे यहाँ जो तहजीब है, गंगा जमुनी तहजीब है हिंदुओं में, वो बरकरार है.
राम भक्त के नाते से ही सारा काम वहाँ टिका है. राम भक्त के नाते से ही सारा काम हो रहा है. जो भी इसमें जुड़े हैं सर राम भक्त के कारण से ही काम कर रहे हैं. भव्य दिव्य राम का मंदिर बनेगा और सर राम भक्त के कारण से ही बनेगा.
कि बहुत लोग आने को उत्सुक हैं, ना आने का उन्हें दुख है, लेकिन मंदिर बन जाएगा तब रामलला बैठेंगे, तब बहुत बड़ा जन समुदाय यहाँ इकट्ठा होगा. शायद अयोध्या में जगह न दिखाई पड़े इतने लोग आएंगे.
Dinesh Sharma, the Deputy Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, I spoke to him yesterday about the preparations in the temple town and also at a time when there is a COVID scare as well. Not only a subordinate pujari of the main priest who will be in fact performing the puja at the Bhoomi, in fact the groundbreaking, the Bhoomi Pujan ceremony on 5th, has tested positive for COVID-19. There are 16 policemen, those who have also tested positive. Massive testing is going across the state, across the city of Ayodhya. How is the city and the administration of Uttar Pradesh preparing for this mega event? Listen in to the Deputy Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Dinesh Sharma. For many years, the Karyashala, where I'm standing right now, was waiting. I mean, there were carving going on, stones were brought in here from all across the country, and all that you see behind me are the pillars that were waiting to be put in the temple whenever the court was to decide on that day. Now, the Bhumi Pujan is going to happen on August 5th. And all these pillars which were waiting for some action, which were waiting to be used now, are being cleaned as the date for the temple, at least for the starting of the construction of the temple, has been decided. How is Uttar Pradesh and Ayodhya gearing up for this? To talk more about this entire program, I have Deputy Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Dinesh Sharma, who is joining us on the broadcast. Dinesh ji, namaskar, bahut bahut shukriya aapka India Today se baat karne ke liye. Main aapse janna chahunga kis tarike ki taiyariyan hain 5 August ki. Ayodhya jo abhi tak intezar mein thi, wo ab bhumi pujan dekhegi 5 tarikh ko, kya alag milega logo ko Ayodhya mein dekhne ke liye?
Dekhiye, Ayodhya nagari apne aap mein aitihasik hai. और ऐतिहासिक में एक इतिहास का पन्ना और जुड़ रहा है कि 500 साल की प्रतीक्षा पूरी होने वाली है और इस प्रतीक्षा में श्री राम जन्मभूमि पर भगवान मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम राम का मंदिर का निर्माण हो, ये जो लोग चाह रहे थे इतनी लंबी प्रतीक्षा के बाद उनकी आज इच्छा पूरी हो रही है, तो ये दृश्य अपने आप में बड़ा अनुपम और अनूठा है। लोग तो यहाँ पर जो लोग श्री राम जन्मभूमि मंदिर निर्माण के आंदोलन से जुड़े थे उनकी संख्या करोड़ों में है और सभी के मन में था कि ऐसा दृश्य को देखने के लिए वो उपस्थित हो सकें, लेकिन कोरोना संक्रमण को देखते हुए जो श्री राम जन्मभूमि मंदिर ट्रस्ट है उसने अपील करी है कि जो अपने दीपोत्सव को का जो वातावरण है वो लोग अपने घरों पर बनाएं, अपने वहाँ पर 5-5 दिए जलाएँ, अखंड पाठ का गायन करें और जो लाइव टेलीकास्ट होगा उसका श्रवण करें, उसको देखें जो दूरदर्शन से उसका होगा। तो ये सारी चीज़ें इस तरीके से देखते हुए किया गया कि कोरोना के संक्रमण का जो दुष्प्रभाव है वो किसी पर ना पड़े, इसलिए एकदम सीमित संख्या में मात्र सैकड़ों में लोग यहाँ पर आ रहे हैं और जो लोग भी यहाँ पर आएंगे उनका पूरे पंडाल को सैनिटाइज करके और उनके दूर दूर बैठने की व्यवस्था को सुनिश्चित किया गया है।
जिस तरीके से मंदिर को लेकर अब एक 3 साल का समय तय किया गया है, अयोध्या का बिल्कुल जो बदलाव है, क्योंकि यहाँ के लोग जब भी हम लोग उनसे बातें करी उनका ये भी कहना था कि मंदिर एक आस्था के साथ साथ यहाँ के लिए एक अयोध्या की इकोनॉमी के लिए भी बहुत बड़ा फैक्टर होगा, टूरिज्म के लिए बहुत बड़ा फैक्टर होगा, उसके लिए क्या सरकार के पास कुछ प्लान तैयार है?
तमाम एक आधुनिक अयोध्या के निर्माण की पूरी व्यवस्था माननीय मुख्यमंत्री योगी आदित्यनाथ जी का जो विजन था उसमें समाहित है कि एक ऐसी अयोध्या का निर्माण हो जिस अयोध्या में प्राचीन ऐतिहासिकता, धार्मिक ऐतिहासिकता हो, लेकिन उसके साथ साथ नवीन सुविधाएं हो जिससे जो पर्यटक वहां पे आवे वो रह सकें, वो घूम फिर सकें, जिससे हमारा अर्थ का जो संचयन है वो भी वहां से हो सके।
कुछ पुलिसकर्मी जो पुजारी हैं उनके सहयोगी कोरोना से ग्रसित हैं, यहाँ पर उनको कोरोना हो गया है, उसको लेकर लोगों में बहुत चिंता है, प्रधानमंत्री क्योंकि खुद यहां पर आने वाले हैं, अयोध्या में क्या इंतजाम होंगे कि जो बाहर से लोग आ रहे हैं उन्हें बचाया जा सके, और अयोध्या वासी भी ये पूछना चाहेंगे कि अयोध्या में कितना इंतजाम है, कल अगर ये सब कार्यक्रम के बाद भी किसी को कोरोना हो जाए तो उसके रख रखाव के लिए, उसकी देखभाल के लिए क्या इंतजाम है दिनेश जी?
देखिए, आप पूरा देख रहे होंगे, एक तो हमारे अयोध्या के हॉस्पिटल पहले से ही अलर्ट हैं और सुरक्षा की पूरी मुस्तैदी से व्यवस्था की गई है। तीसरी चीज़, अगर आप पंडाल को देखेंगे तो पंडाल में दूर दूर तक बैठने के स्पष्ट संकेत अंकित किए गए हैं कि कितनी दूरी पर किसको बैठना है, इसके स्पष्ट संकेत वहां पर अंकित हैं, तो एक सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग को बनाए रखा जाएगा। पंडाल का पूरा सैनिटाइजेशन की प्रक्रिया पूरी करने के उपरांत ही लोग वहां पर बैठेंगे, तो ये सारी सुरक्षा के जितने भी उपाय हो सकते हैं सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग के, वो सारे उपाय किए जा रहे हैं। लोगों से कहा गया है कि जो भी आएंगे वो मास्क लगाकर वहां पर आए।
दिग्विजय सिंह कह रहे हैं कि मुहूर्त जो है वो ठीक नहीं है ये पूजन का, साहब कहते हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री को जाना है तो जाएं, इंडिविजुअल कैपेसिटी में जाएं, एक सेक्युलर देश का प्रधानमंत्री इस तरीके के रिलीजियस कार्यक्रम में, धार्मिक कार्यक्रम में जाते हुए शोभा नहीं देते।
देखिए, राम जन्मभूमि का मुहूर्त तो जो भगवान जी जो सबका मुहूर्त तय करते हैं, उनका मुहूर्त दूसरा कौन तय करेगा, वो तो अपने आप में परिपक्व और पुष्ट है, लेकिन दिग्विजय सिंह जी का मुहूर्त जरूर अच्छा नहीं कि राजनीतिक रूप में वो इस समय वनवास की स्थिति में है। उनका हमेशा बयान जब भी आता है तो नकारात्मक ही आता है, सकारात्मक बयान की उनसे उम्मीद भी नहीं की जा सकती।
थैंक यू सो मच फॉर स्पीकिंग टू इंडिया टुडे। ऑलराइट, फ्रॉम द राम की पैड़ी, लेट मी नाउ गिव यू अनदर साइट ऑफ अयोध्या विच इज क्वाइट फेमिलियर, क्वाइट पॉपुलर एज वेल। दिस इज द सरयू रिवर एंड वी आर ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ द सरयू रिवर राइट नाउ। इन फैक्ट every evening this is where the preparations, this is where the aarti of the Sarayu river takes place. I'll just ask Dinesh, he will just turn around and show you. This is the deck where the aarti takes place every evening, and at this point of time you can see these flags being put, the Kesariya flags which are being put here with Jai Shri Ram written on them, all in the preparations for August 5th when the Prime Minister would be here for the groundbreaking ceremony of the Ram Temple. Meanwhile, veteran BJP leader Uma Bharti has opted out of the invitee list of the Ram Janmabhoomi Pujan. Uma Bharti, a stalwart of the Ram Temple movement, she is also an accused as far as the demolition of the Babri Mosque is concerned. She, in fact, has said that she is not going to, she would travel to Ayodhya, but after the groundbreaking ceremony takes place. She doesn't want to, in fact, she said that between traveling from Bhopal, coming to Ayodhya, she might get in touch with people and contract coronavirus. She doesn't want to put anybody under any sort of risk. Bharti says she has decided to skip the rituals at Ayodhya to protect Prime Minister Narendra Modi and hundreds of others at the site of the temple. She added she would visit the site of the temple only after everyone else has left. She's saying that she would be here at the Sarayu Ghat doing the puja here while the Bhumi Pujan would be going on at the Ram Janmabhoomi temple at the at the Parisar, Ram Janmabhoomi Parisar. She also said that India Today had earlier reported that keeping in mind the coronavirus SOPs, veteran leaders like Lal Krishna Advani, Murli Manohar Joshi will join through video conferencing, and no union minister or chief minister apart from the chief minister of Uttar Pradesh would be present at this ceremony. Going across to my colleague Himendra, who is joining us with more details on this story. Himendra, Uma Bharti taking that decision, many are saying that possibly it has been told to her in a polite fashion that don't come here. There are many other leaders, those who will be miffed because they have not been invited. She's taken the excuse of COVID, but actually the government doesn't want too many people to come here, including the stalwarts like, L.K. Advani.
Ram Janam Bhumi movement led by L.K. Advani, and also of which Mr. Murli Manohar Joshi was part in the 90s. So she was to be there, but it appears right now that she has chosen not to be there at the time when the actual ceremony happened, because today when she left Bhopal, she first tweeted and said that she doesn't want to put anyone's life in risk because she's going to travel and she might get in contact with people who are already having this virus, and as this virus is spreading, she doesn't want to put anyone's life at risk, and she's going to be there at the temple after the ceremony, after the dignitaries have left, after the Prime Minister has left. She wants to be there at the temple. So clearly she is looking for an opportunity beyond the foundation laying ceremony as well, and she, at the moment, it appears that she does not want to be part of the ceremony over there for whatever reasons.
Well, I mean, we can put two and two together, but let's leave it there. In fact, Himendra Uma Bharti, who was a key figure in the Ram Janmabhoomi movement, in fact, an accused in the Babri Masjid demolition case, will not be coming here. She said she had got the invitation, but now she's keeping her interest at the back and keeping the interest, in the view of the coronavirus in front. There is a chopper I can hear which is coming, but possibly it is the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath, who is going to come here and take a look at the preparations. But, yesterday the Home Minister, Amit Shah, tested positive for coronavirus. There are governors, chief ministers, those who are testing for coronavirus. In Ayodhya as well, as I was telling you earlier, 16 policemen, a priest who is subordinate to the main priest who would be performing the puja, have also tested positive. There is a sharp spike in the cases in Ayodhya as well. That has instilled fear as far as the ceremony is concerned among the locals and the administration as well. Massive preparations are being, in fact, conducted to make sure it is coronavirus free, as the Prime Minister would be coming at this event along with 200 other dignitaries.
Ayodhya gets all set to host the historic Bhumi Pujan ceremony that will mark the beginning of the temple construction. But the festive atmosphere is clouded by the sharp rise in coronavirus cases. The official government data reveals that the district is adding more cases recoveries per day. Doubling rate is also down to 12 days. A junior priest at the makeshift temple and four security personnel on temple duty were found to be COVID-19 positive on Thursday. 10 security personnel on duty, 2 were found positive. As a precautionary measure, nearly 200 people who could play a role in the Bhumi Pujan at Mandir site had undergone antigen tests.
We are keeping the vigil. We are conducting tests. For all the people who come in the vicinity of VVIP, we have to make it sure that none of them is positive. And that is our prime concern. All the people who visit as guests there, for their safety as well, we have to keep the whole premises COVID-free.
The COVID cases haven't affected the preparations.
Corona के कारण से किसी को कोई परेशानी ना हो, दूर-दूर बैठने के लिए है, और दूर-दूर बैठ करके एक दूसरे से वो corona के कारण से लगे न बैठें, इसकी व्यवस्था हो रही है, और बरसात से बचाव करने के लिए व्यवस्था हो रही है, साथ ही साथ किसी और किसी दुर्घटना
The Bhumi Pujan will take place even as social gatherings are banned across the country. The government is expected to lay out norms for social distancing during the ceremony, which will be attended by many big names soon.
As Ayodhya gears up for the mega event on 5th of August, when groundbreaking or the Bhumi Pujan will be done by Prime Minister himself at Ayodhya, the surge in COVID cases had cast the big shadow on this program. With Neeraj Kumar, this is Kumar Abhishek in Ayodhya for India Today.
All right, COVID is going to be a scare, but just let me tell you, there are a lot of people. That's what the problem in Ayodhya is. You will see a lot of people sitting here as well, many not without their face mask on. And that is, ladies and gentlemen, is a recipe for disaster. This big religious event, but you have to be responsible for your own safety and for safety of others as well. Now, moving on, there is politics. Every time you talk about the Ram Janmabhoomi temple, the Ayodhya movement, it has had political and social discord at many times. The hope was that this verdict is going to be a new chapter of inclusiveness of the country moving together, but politics continues to be played on this. Congress leader Digvijay Singh has drawn a bizarre COVID religion parallel. I beg your pardon. Digvijay Singh linked the case of top BJP leaders testing positive for COVID-19 to Ram Janmabhoomi Pujan. Digvijay Singh claimed that the temple is being constructed at an inauspicious time, and that is why the BJP leaders are getting divine punishment. He called Home Minister Amit Shah and other BJP leaders COVID infection a result of ignoring Hindu faith. The former Congress General Secretary also asked for quarantine of Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Adityanath and said they shouldn't join the Bhumi Pujan. Congress MP Karthik Chidambaram had earlier claimed Ram Mandir Bhumi Pujan is happening at Rahu Kalam. He added he is against building any more places of worship.
मैंने अखबारों में पढ़ा है सोनिया जी अस्पताल में थी शायद कल छुट्टी हुई होगी
जी
तो दिग्विजय जी ने उनको अपनी ट्वीट में शामिल क्यों नहीं किया ये जो संयोग होते हैं कि कोई बीमार पड़ा अपने सार्वजनिक कर्तव्यों को पूरा करते करते वो इस संक्रमण से बचना कई बार मुश्किल हो जाता है वो मुश्किल हुआ इसको किसी देवता का कोप मानना दिग्विजय सिंह जी से हमको यही उम्मीद है
जिस प्रकार से न्यायालय में कपिल सिब्बल ने विघ्न डालने की कोशिश की
जो असफल रहे। उसी प्रकार से दिग्विजय सिंह अब भूमि पूजन में विघ्न डालने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। वह उसी एजेंडा के तहत है जिसके तहत कांग्रेस पार्टी सोनिया गांधी के नेतृत्व में राम मंदिर के प्रति अपने विरोध को जगजाहिर करती रही है।
Himendra Sharma is live with us. Himendra, expect Digvijay Singh to in fact draw the most bizarre parallels for political statements. I mean, I can understand what his position is as far as the Ram Janmabhoomi temple issue is concerned, but drawing a parallel, I mean, also in a way only extending the superstition as far as COVID-19 and other bizarre claims which have been made around it.
Well, as far as the Congress is concerned, I think there is a realization and understanding within the party that the BJP is trying to run away with the credit for the Ram temple, and they somehow see that the timing of the foundation laying ceremony and ultimately 2024 elections are there in their side as well. So they do not want to do that, and for that, Digvijay Singh, if you look at back at his tweets, he has been talking about it, and he is saying that the actual Shilanyas was done by Rajiv Gandhi. And also, he's trying to invoke the Hindu religion and also Muhurat and all these things, and trying to hit at the hardcore Hindu section, trying to tell them that it's not just the BJP. In fact, yes, in the morning today, he was quoted in some newspaper saying that the BJP and RSS are not the sole proprietors of Hindus. So he is trying his best, and I think he is doing this job for the Congress. He's taking the hit for that, because it's not possible that the Congress high command just simply ignores him, and without their approval, he keeps on saying the things that he keeps saying.
He does that, isn't it? And quite often is Digvijay Singh making such statements. But the confusion in the Congress party is quite clear when it comes to taking a stand as far as the Ram Janmabhoomi temple issue is concerned. Kamal Nath is, in fact, starting today the Hanuman part, Hanuman Chalisa part at his residence, and has also asked Congress leaders in MP to follow. On the other hand, the central leadership is absolutely mum on the issue. Thank you, Himendra, for joining us. With that, we're slipping into a very short break on this special broadcast, which is coming to you live from the banks of the Sariu River here in Ayodhya. On the other side, there is another aspect to this temple being constructed, and I asked that to Dinesh Sharma as well. The economic angle to all this, the property prices in Ayodhya since the time the court decided on the Ram Janmabhoomi temple issue have gone up. I mean, they have soared in anticipation that economic activity will now speed up in the holy city of Ayodhya. That coming up after a short break. All right, welcome back to this special presentation, which is coming to you live from the temple town of Ayodhya, which is all decked up for the groundbreaking ceremony of the Ram temple on August 5th. Now, before this verdict of the Supreme Court, ever since we have been coming here, a lot of people have been talking about the economic development of Ayodhya, how Ayodhya was neglected despite many, many decades of being in the hot spot, in the spotlight of the political social upheaval across the country. Now, as soon as the verdict came, there has been a renewed anticipation of of the economic activities restarting in Ayodhya. Lakhs of pilgrims are going to come after the temple would be completed. That will need a full economic boon as far as Ayodhya is concerned. Hotels and a full tourism, religious tourism industry, which is ready to spread its wings in the temple town. This is resulting in the property prices of Ayodhya really, really going up.
जन्म भूमि पे मंदिर बनेगा, जन्म भूमि पे मंदिर बनेगा, जिनके रखवाले बजरंग बली हैं, जिनके रखवाले बजरंग बली।
For years, the city of Ayodhya was synonymous to the Mandir Masjid dispute. Hindu pilgrims and religious tourists would flock to the city to pay a visit to what they believed to be the birthplace of Ram. To look at the idol of the infant Ram, but they mostly came away with disappointed in the whole experience. Despite being a pilgrimage site and a temple town for centuries, Ayodhya was never ready to cater to the needs of an influx of travelers. But that problem is being tackled now. Ayodhya is getting a facelift. Along with the building of the Grand Ram Temple, the people in charge say that the town is set to get a revamped riverfront and an international scale bus terminus.
सरकार की योजना नव अयोध्या नई अयोध्या डेवलप करने की है. इसमें तमाम चीजें सुविधाएं होगी. बहुत अच्छा जो है डेवलपमेंट होने वाला है. सारी सुविधाएं होगी. तमाम आश्रम होंगे. तमाम रेस्टोरेंट होंगे. तमाम जो है माल होंगे.
And one fallout of the Supreme Court decision clearing the way for the building of the new Ram temple in Ayodhya was that the property prices began to skyrocket.
बहुत फर्क पड़ गया है. पहले वो 500 रुपए की स्क्वायर फीट पे थी. आज वो जमीनें 1500 रुपए हो गई हैं.
अच्छा.
और जो किसान पहले 3 लाख रुपए हिस्सा बेचते थे, आज वो लोग 1500 रुपए हिस्सा बेच रहे हैं. जो भी आ रहे हैं सब होटल के लिए आ रहे हैं और धर्मशाला के लिए आ रहे हैं, रिजोर्ट के लिए आ रहे हैं. सब यही लोग जमीनें लेने के लिए आ रहे हैं.
अयोध्या में भगवान श्री राघवेंद्र सरकार का जन्मभूमि का मंदिर बन जाने से अयोध्या वर्ल्ड फेमस हो गया है. इस कारण यहाँ के लोग जमीन में खोज रहे हैं. कोई मंदिर बनवाने को उद्देश्य खोज रहा है और कोई रिजॉर्ट बनवाने के लिए खोज रहा है, कोई होटल लिए खोज रहा है. इस तरीके से यहाँ पे जमीन की मांगें भी बढ़ गई हैं और जमीन की कीमतें भी बढ़ गई हैं.
Not just the real estate sector, many local business people believe that the city's overall economy will now thrive because of the new temple.
वास्तव में जब से राम मंदिर का जजमेंट आया है उससे काफी हम लोग उत्साहित हैं और कहीं ना कहीं एक पूरा विश्वास है हमको कि आने वाले समय में हम लोग के लिए रोजगार और अच्छा होगा और हमारी दुकान भी और चलेगी.
अगर हनुमान जी ने चाहा वो राम जी वही यहाँ से विराजमान हो जाएंगे तो सब आगे कार्यक्रम बढ़ ही करेगा.
लेकिन जिस हिसाब से एक राम मंदिर का निर्माण चालू हो रहा है उस हिसाब से जो है जनसंख्या बढ़ने के है कि श्रद्धालु यहाँ पे जो है जोर शोर से आने के उसमें रहेंगे.
सबसे बड़ी बात है कि राम मंदिर बन रहा है हम लोग का इसी से और इससे दुकानदारी हर चीज बढ़ेगी.
In Jai Singhpur village of Ayodhya, potter Ashok Kumar is readying his big order of diyas for what the residents are calling a second Diwali.
1.5 lakh diya ka order mila hai Ram Janmabhoomi pe, Ram Padi pe, Ram Janmabhoomi pe jalega. Abhi ye jo hai corona na hota to ye samajh lijiyega ki double Diwali hoti hum log ko jo hai.
While he gets the 1.5 lakh earthen lamps ready for the temple inauguration, Kumar too believes business will be better after the temple is built.
मंदिर बन रहा है, हो सकता अभी और हम लोग का विकास थोड़ा बढ़ जाए जो है.
People in Ayodhya believe that the beginning of Ram Mandir construction will boost the local economy. Meanwhile, the government is also planning to develop the temple city into the most popular destination for religious tourism, and it is expected that in the near future more development projects will be announced here by both central and the state government.
India Today is going to bring you the biggest coverage as far as the one of the most historical event in our living memory, the groundbreaking ceremony of the Ram Temple. We will bring you more news updates from the ground in Ayodhya, the biggest team here till the 5th of August. That's all the time that I have in this special news bulletin. The Sariu River, and it's overcast right now in Ayodhya. The Sariu River is, in fact, it's a quite fast current here, and also the level of the river has gone up. So we are hoping that this doesn't create any problem, at least till the 5th of August.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.